Hello, welcome to our next day of learning for the Sefer Chafetz Chaim. Today we're on day 14, which is called Causing Strife or Hurt. So the Chafetz Chaim goes into the different types of negative speech that are forbidden. So he talks about the commandment of Rechilas, of not being allowed to tell somebody what somebody else said of them. So he gave a scenario. Imagine there is a principal in the school and then there's an executive director and they have a benefit. And the executive director doesn't love how the benefit event turned out. And he mentions to one of the board members, well, it's all because of the principal. So he goes back to the principal and he says, you know, this is what the board member said about you. He thinks it's all because of you that the event didn't turn out to his liking. And the principal says, me? How is it my fault? He's the one who didn't put together any meetings or put enough work into it. So now this board member goes back to the executive director and says, the principal says it's really your fault because you didn't put enough work into it. Then that person says, really? Well, I did make meetings, but the principal didn't show up to any of them. So now the board member tells the principal that, and the principal says, didn't show up to them because he never confirmed anything. And this goes back and forth. And before you know it, you have this full-blown machlokes, this full-blown fight. The Torah says that when you do that, you are violating a commandment that says, one should not be like Korach and his assembly. Who was Korach? Korach was a man that lived in the time of Moshe, of Moses, and he started a huge rebellion against Moshe. He told people horrible things about Moshe. You know what? Moshe, he just wants all the power. Moshe loves that everybody should just, you know, worship him because he's the closest to God. And he started this huge rift in the Jewish people. And eventually, the Torah says that the ground was swallowed up Korach and his followers. So every time we create Lashon Hara by speaking Rechilas, when you tell somebody else what someone said about them, you are violating a horrible commandment. You are creating so much strife for no reason. It's one of the worst things you could possibly do, is to repeat to somebody what someone else said about them. If there is no purpose and no toelas, and there is nothing that will come out of it except for pure gossip, just to let them know. What is them knowing half the time going to do about anything in this situation except make everybody involved upset? And it's not helpful. And it becomes this volleyball game of back and forth of, he said this about you, he said this about you, he said that about you. I mean, think about even when people are going through divorces, how much of this volleyball of what he said about you and this is what he said about you. And half the time, most of the time, it doesn't do any good. It doesn't serve any purpose except create a worse and worse scenario that needs to be created than what needed to be created. So the next thing that the Chafetz Chaim says is explicitly forbidden in the Torah is something called onas davarim, hurting somebody with words. Now, we know, we've known since we've had this mitzvah for thousands of years, that words actually are hurtful, right? Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words will never hurt me. No. Words can be even worse sometimes than physical abuse. Verbal abuse is completely not allowed according to the Torah. We know now that there's so much psychological damage that can be done by what you tell someone, right? So much of somebody's self-esteem is dependent on how he thinks the world perceives him. When you tell someone, when you tell a child or even an adult, you're incompetent, you're stupid, you're not smart, any of these horrible things, you're basically implanting in their brain how they're gonna view themselves. And yes, there are people that are very confident that can handle any type of abuse towards them. And that's nice, but for the majority of people, that is not the case. And even I would venture to say people who seem like they could take any abuse, probably deep down are affected from it. And onas davarim is really not allowed according to the Torah. Now, onas davarim, hurting people with words, takes many forms. And we think of it as just verbal abuse, but it's more than that. According to the Torah, and according to this commandment, you are not allowed to remind somebody of their past if it's something that will embarrass them. So let's say somebody in the past was in a really bad state, they weren't a great person in the past, they didn't have a great relationship with a family member in the past, things in their past that maybe they don't love to think about or discuss, when you discuss that with them, not even with somebody else, with just them there, you are violating onas devarim, hurting someone with words. Now, if there are people around as you're doing it and you're informing the whole crowd about what this person did in their past, that becomes lashon hara on top of onas devarim. You're hurting them with words, you're embarrassing them, and you're speaking lashon hara. So that just makes it an even larger sin. But even if it's just you and the person, you cannot remind them of their past if it's not something that they want to talk about or that they feel proud of. So we see from this chapter how careful we have to be with our words, how sensitive we have to be towards people, and how mindful we have to be when we're speaking, to just be a little bit more cautious. Wow, when I'm about to tell my sister what my mom said, my friend, what our other friend said, is this necessary? Am I about to cause a huge fight here? I have to think twice about that. Have a great day.